Good evening. You're watching the news from the Sultanate of Oman Television. First, the headlines. His Highness Sayyid Fahd bin Mahmoud Al Said, their Highnesses and Excellencies members of the Council of Ministers, make an inspection visit to Muscat International Airport project. Percent of Muscat International Airport project is completed as the Minister of Transport and Communications confirms it will be handing over the northern part of the project by the end of coming June. The Royal Air Force of Oman celebrates the graduation of a new batch of pilots and air officers. Those are the headlines, and now the news in detail. His Majesty Sultan Qaboos has received a cable of thanks from His Excellency President Chou Mali of Sayasong of Laos in reply to His Majesty's cable of greetings on his country's National Day. His Highness Sayyid Fahd bin Mahmoud Al Said, Deputy Prime Minister of the Council of Ministers, their Highnesses and their Excellencies members of the Council of Ministers had an inspection tour this morning to the completing stage of Muscat International Airport. They were received on arrival by His Excellency Dr. Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Futaisi, Minister of Transport and Communications, and a number of officials of the ministry, besides members of the technical committee supervising airports projects. At the start, the Minister of Transport and Communications presented a visual display on the airports in Oman, included contents of the projects, work progress, percentage achieved, and preparedness of bodies for operation. Then they were acquainted with the completed stages of Muscat International Airport, which exceeded 86% outside works, including control tower, northern runway, building of public authority for civil aviation, metrology complex, and air navigation. That was in addition to current works surrounding passengers' buildings, such as roads leading to the airport buildings. The minister mentioned that the Muscat International Airport design took into consideration future expansions after that His Highness and the attendees took up a tour inside the passengers building, where they saw its facilities such as clearing travels and security procedures and a duty-free area located in heart of the building. That was in addition to airport hotel, and acquainted with contents of the northern wing, which is one of the three wings the airport consists of. Then they stood at the design, which was derived from the distinctive Omani architecture. The tour also covered arrival hall at the northern wing and looked at its contents. His Highness and the attendees expressed their admiration of the work of progress at the airport and the high quality architectural level of the premises. His Highness Sayyid Fahd bin Mahmoud Al Said praised efforts exerted to complete airport projects and other giant projects covering all parts of the Sultanate, which all come within the context of wise vision and continuous attention of His Majesty Sultan Qaboos to continue a comprehensive construction march for all vital utilities in the Sultanate. His Highness also expressed his thanks and that of the Council of Ministers for all those who are in charge of the important project, officials of the Ministry of Transport and Communications, Technical Committee supervising airports projects, and Board of Directors of the Project Implementing Committee, wishing them all continuous success. At the end of the visit, His Highness stressed to the Board of Directors of the Implementing Company of Muscat International Airport Project the necessity to complete the project at the required speed and quality as the other strategic projects.
We have bodies in all three pairs. The other thing that we have in here as well is
illuminated.
So we
runs from north to south. Under these immigration counters, we have metal mesh canopy. The beauty of this space is passengers, when they have family and friends who are greeting their passengers.
Oh.
Muscat International Airport project work completion progress reached 86% of the full operation. His Excellency Dr. Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Futaisi, Minister of Transport and Communications, mentioned that the airport will be handed over as per the previously announced schedule by the end of 2016. Construction and development in Oman airports are underway after the launch of the Salalah Airport in November, whose construction was worth 365 million Omani riyals. Muscat International Airport is on the final stage with 94% already achieved. The Minister of Transport and Communications said that the passengers touched at Salalah Airport amounted to 1 million by the end of 2015, and it can accommodate up to 2 million passengers annually, with possible increase up to 6 million travelers. The regional airports in Sohar, Rukum and Ras Al Hajj each have capacity of 500,000 passengers annually, and all of them were equipped with runway extends to 4 kilometers to accommodate biggest airplanes. Muscat International Airport is designed to accommodate 12 million passengers annually, classified A class in the service label. It consists of VIP lounge and halls for first and business classes. The building has 29 gates attached to 40 aero bridges for passengers to board and disembark planes, 16 land gates to move passengers by buses. The airport also is equipped with a building for car park, which can accommodate 7,000 vehicles. The project also has a 4-star hotel with capacity of 90 rooms and possible for future expansion. 18,000 personnel are currently working in the project, which is the readiness team to receive the northern part of the building in June this year. All phases of airport projects in the Sultanate were already awarded, and they will not be affected by oil prices decrease. This was announced by His Excellency Dr. Ahmed bin Mohammed Al Futaisi, Minister of Transport and Communications. He added that the budget airline will be complementing with Oman Air, and it will achieve economic income to the Sultanate. The Royal Air Force of Oman, RAFO, celebrated at the military parade ground at Gala Bez and the Sultan Qaboos Air Academy today the graduation of a new batch of pilots and air officers, as well as university officers' corps and limited service officers' corps, in a ceremony held under the auspices of His Excellency Said Khalid bin Hilal bin Saud Al Busaidi, Minister of the Diwan of the Royal Court. The ceremony began when the column of the graduates performed the military salute while the RAFO music band played the royal anthem. His Excellency the Minister of the Diwan of the Royal Court inspected the front column of graduates. Then the graduates marched before the main dais in slow motion, accompanied by musical pieces played by the RAFO music band. Then the chief guest pinned aviation wing on the graduated pilots. After that, the graduates had chanted the RAFO anthem and proclaimed thrice, "Long live His Majesty Sultan Qaboos, the Supreme Commander of the Armed Forces." Then the Minister of the Diwan of the Royal Court distributed aviation instructor certificates to the pilots. His Excellency Sayyid Khalid bin Hilal Al Busaidi, Minister of the Diwan of the Royal Court, expressed his delight to be honored with the participation of RAFO to graduates this batch of the sons of the dear country, who will join their brothers at the RAFO service to defend the country and safeguard its achievements. He thanked those in charge of RAFO for the efforts exerted and the good organization made for this ceremony. And celebrating graduation of a new batch of pilots and air officers, in addition to university officers' corps and limited service officers' corps in Royal Air Force of Oman, Air Vice Marshal Mathur bin Ali Al Ubaidani, Commander of Royal Air Force of Oman, handed over certificates of diploma in military sciences for pilots and officers graduated from Sultan Qaboos Air Academy, and appreciation certificates for the graduates of limited service officers' corps. Still to come in News Bulletin. Omania Supercars Tours is conducted to showcase touristic attractions of the Sultanate.
شاركونا في مهرجان مسقط. مهرجان مسقط 2016 ابتداء من 14 من يناير وحتى 13 من فبراير 2016.
Reviewing several issues of concern to the Arab Joint Security Work, top discussions at the meeting of the His Excellency Sayyid Hamoud bin Faisal Al Busaidi, Minister of Interior, and Dr. Mohammed bin Ali Koman, Secretary General of the Council of Arab Interior Ministers. The visit of Dr. Koman to the Sultanate comes within the framework of his consultative tour in a number of Arab countries in preparation for the 33rd session of the Council of Arab Interior Ministers. Enhancing relations of cooperation between Royal Oman Police and the Secretariat General of the Council of Arab Interior Ministers, top discussions of His Excellency Lieutenant General Hassan bin Mohsin Ashraqi, Inspector General of Police and Customs, while receiving His Excellency Dr. Mohammed bin Ali Koman, Secretary General of the Council of Arab Interior Ministers, who is currently visiting the Sultanate. During the meeting, both sides exchanged cordial talks. More than 5 billion and 200 million Omani riyals is the real estate trading value in the Sultanate during 2015, marking a rise of 78% comparing with 2014. The good activity of the trading value came as a result of the increase of real estate transactions in various governorates of the Sultanate. 388,211 real estate transactions were recorded in the governorate of Muscat, while 69,566 transactions in the governorate of North Baltina and 58,680 in the governorate of South Baltina. The fees collected total during the year 2015 reached 62,054,000 Omani riyals, making a rise of 25% comparing with 2014. Various supercars with drivers from all around the world gathered in the Sultanate to start a tour that crosses some of the most important sites and to promote tourism as well. More details in the following report by Sultan bin Saif Al-Sarai.
The Ministry of Tourism, in cooperation with Supercars Club Arabia, organized Omania Tour to promote tourism in Oman. It started today and will last until the 28th of this month.
We are organizing and managing tours around the world. We have two tours around the world. One is arranged in the winter time, which is in the GCC, and one is either in Europe or America. On top of this, we are looking for exclusivity, not just in tours. We are planning other projects, such as a members' lounge, which is to be placed in different parts in the GCC, which is actually under process at the moment.
The tour started from Oman, and the drivers will drive around 1,200 kilometers from Muscat and pass through the Sultanate's other cities such as Sur, Nizwa, before crossing the United Arab Emirates border and heading to Al Ain and Abu Dhabi.
The main aim is to focus on bringing people together, bringing people to Oman, letting them see Oman for the first time. A lot of people have come from around the world, even in the Middle East. They've never been here before. And Oman, mashallah, is a very safe place, beautiful place. We have great roads, and we worked well with the Ministry of Tourism. They helped us a lot. And Oman is just a beautiful place to visit and beautiful roads.
Omania Tour is a highly anticipated event that gathers the region's premier exotic automobile enthusiasts in an exciting circuit.
I am looking forward to driving on your roads, and actually, I've never been to Sur, so that'll be the first time. Nizwa, I went to about 15 years ago, so I'm really looking forward to driving and also going and seeing, from what I remembered, because you had redeveloped the marketplace, right? And you have turned it into a beautiful space for tourism, so I'm looking forward to seeing that and driving through up into the Jebel.
I mean, for me, I'm obviously not desperately familiar with Oman. This is only my second visit to the Sultanate, so it's an opportunity to sort of see and explore. And in the first couple of days here have been amazing. I love the place. I'm really looking forward to sort of seeing the places we're going to be stopping off along the way.
The tour was organized following the overwhelming response Supercars Club Arabia received for its Europia tour, which was held in August 2015 to several European countries. Such initiative doesn't touch entertainment or sport aspects only, but it's considered as a good chance to promote tourism in the Sultanate, as these cars will go through various villages and cities in Oman. Sultan bin Saif al-Sarai, Muscat.
National Ferries Company and Administration of Marine Transport Free Zone in island of Qasim in Iran signed a memorandum of understanding on the sideline of Omani-Iranian exhibition. The exhibition is organized by Oman Chamber of Commerce and Industry Branch in the Governorate of Musandam. The exhibition included Iranian products, crafts, industries, in addition to showcase a number of products and industries from the Governorate. The three-day exhibition on its first version discussed opportunities of investment in economy sectors between the Governorate of Musandam and the Governorate of Hormuzjan in Iran, in addition to fine development and economic projects. The exhibition considered as a good chance for owners of small and medium-sized projects. Now for the general weather forecast. Clear skies will prevail over the Sultanate with chances of low clouds and fog late at night and early morning in the governorates of Wusta, Mufal, South and North Sharqiyya and coastal areas overlooking Sea of Oman and Arabian Sea. Winds will be easterly to southeasterly light to moderate and seas will be slight to the maximum wave height of 1 meter. This is the Sultanate of Oman Television. Before we enter tonight's bulletin, here are the main points once again. His Highness Said Fahd bin Mahmoud Al Said, their Highnesses and Excellencies members of the Council of Ministers, make an inspection visit to Muscat International Airport project. 86% of Muscat International Airport project is completed. As the Minister of Transport and Communications confirms, it will be handed over the northern part of the project by the end of coming June. And the Royal Air Force of Oman celebrates the graduation of a new batch of pilots and air officers. And with that, we come to the end of tonight's news bulletin from all of us here in the newsroom and studios. Thanks for your time. Good night.